Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you 5 different ways to use a simple text as a cinematic titles. And trust me, this is very easy to create in DaVinci Resolve, and don't miss the last one, which is very interesting. So this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so this is DaVinci Resolve 18.6 and I have a video clip on the timeline as you can see. And now let's create the first title. So just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on new fusion composition, and this is gonna be the title one. So I'm gonna call it T1 and let's make the duration 10 seconds long, frame rate 30, and click on create. So this is the fusion composition. Let's drag and drop the fusion composition on the timeline just like that. Perfect. And then go to the fusion page. Here we have to create the cinematic title. So this is the media out. Let's drag and drop the media out to the side for now. Perfect. And let's start by creating a new text node. So this is the text, drag and drop on the flow window. Drag the text to the viewer. As you can see, we have nothing here. So first of all, we have to type a text over here in this box. You can type anything, whatever you like, just like that. And then we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using the lemon milk font style. Of course, you can select any font style that you like. Now let's set it to light or maybe regular. Now let's down the size of the text. I'm going to set it 0.045 maybe. You can increase the tracking amount as well. I'm going to set the value 1.1. Perfect. Now you can animate the text. It's very simple. First of all, just right click on this preview window, go to guide and turn on this guide for a reference. And now you can check the text. This text is in center, which is absolutely perfect. And now let's animate the opacity. So just go to frame number 60, which is equal to 2 seconds according to 30 frames per second. And then just go to the setting tab. Here you can get this opacity. Just right click on opacity, click on animate, or you can also click on the diamond button here to create a keyframe. It's very simple. And then just go to very first frame of this animation, set the opacity value 0, and then just go to frame number 240, which is equal to 8 seconds. Lock the opacity as it is by clicking on this diamond button, and then just go to the end of this animation and set the opacity 0. Now let's do one more thing. Just go to spline window. Here we have the opacity parameter. Just check this option, click on fit. Here we have all the keyframes. Just select these two keyframes, hit S to smooth, select these two, hit S to smooth. Basically we have to make these keyframes smooth, and then close the spline window. And here we have this type of text animation. Now let's add one more animation to the text. It's very simple. Select the text one, add a transform node. So this is the transform, and I want to use this transform to create a scale animation on the whole text. So just go to the end of this animation, set the size 0.8 maybe, and then right click on size, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the size value default, which is 1, and then go to spline window again. Here we have to make the keyframe smoother. So what we have to do, just uncheck the text 1 because we don't need it. Check the transform, click on fit button, highlight both the keyframes, click on a smooth button, or you can also hit S on the keyboard, and then close the spline window. Now you can simply connect the transform with the media out and go to the edit page, and here we have nice and smooth text animation that you can use as a cinematic title. Now let me show you one more thing. You can create multiple lines. So just go to fusion page. Here we have to duplicate the text node. So just select the text, hit Ctrl C to copy, hit Ctrl V, take a new merge node, hold shift on the keyboard and attach this merge just like that. Just connect the green point, which is the foreground, with this second text. Perfect. And now select the text and drag it down just a little bit. Select the first one and drag it up. You can hold Ctrl and scroll up to zoom in, and now you can fit the text according to you. Now select the second one and change the text just like that, and then you can down the size of the text. Perfect. Now you can align the text right over here. You can also change the tracking amount a little bit more. Perfect. And let's change the timing of the opacity for both the text. So just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. Just uncheck all the nodes and check the second copy of the text. Click on fit, and these are the first keyframe. Select these two keyframes, go to frame number 30, which is equal to 1 second, and move these keyframes right over here, just like that. Now we have a time gap between both the text, as you can see. And then go to spline window, go to edit paste, and here we have nice and smooth text animation, which is looking very cinematic, as you can see. Now let me copy these clips, hit Ctrl C, place the CDI right over here, hit Ctrl V to paste. Just place the CDI on the second clip and then go to the Fusion page. Here we have to apply one more animation on the text as well as the opacity. So what we have to do, just select the text one, go to setting, and here we have the softness. So this time we will add the softness animation as well. So it's very simple. Here we have the X softness and the Y, but we have to animate both at a time. So what we have to do, just right click on the Y, click on expression. Here we have the plus button. Let's connect the Y parameter with the X. So just hold the plus button and connect it with X. If you increase the X, then you can see here Y is also changing the value. Perfect. Now let's animate the X parameter only. So just go to frame number 60, right click on X, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the X value 10. Now we will get opacity as well as blur animation on the text, which is looking nice. Now let me do the same thing with this one. Now let me quickly animate the end of this animation. Now just go to the edit page, and here you can see we have this type of animation, which is looking nice. Now let me show you the another one. So just place the CDI, hit Ctrl V. So this is the copy of this first one, and then place the CDI on it. Click on the Fusion page. Here you can animate the tracking amount as well as the opacity. So you can see here we have the opacity animation, and now let's animate the tracking. So select the text, go to frame number 60, which is equal to 2 seconds, and this is the tracking. So what we have to do, just right click on the tracking, click on animate, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the tracking amount 1.3, and then you can animate the end as well. Just go to frame number 240, right click on tracking, click on set key, go to the end of this animation. Let's set the value 1.3. perfect. Now we have the end animation as well. Perfect. Now let's do the same thing with the second title. Now we have the tracking on the second text as well. You can also make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen. Here we have the character spacing for both the text. Click on fit button, highlight all the keyframes, hit H to smooth, highlight these keyframes, hit H to smooth, and then close the spline window, go to edit paste, and here we have the third text, which is something like this. Perfect. Again, place the CDI right over here, hit Ctrl V to paste, and for the fourth one, just go to the Fusion page, and here we have the text one. Select the text one. This time we will add the write on animation as well as the opacity. So here already we have the opacity animation, and let's animate the write on. So just go to frame number 60, right click on write on, click on animate, go to very first frame, let's set the end value 0. Perfect. We have this type of typing animation. And then just go to frame number 240, right click on write on, click on set key and lock the value as it is. Go to the end of this animation. Let's set the write on value 0. So we have the animation in and animation out just like that. Now you can change the font style as well. So in this case, I'm using this font style for the typewriter kind of font. Now let's change this one as well. Perfect. So here we have this type of text animation, which is looking like a typewriter effect. And then I'm going to do the same animation with the second one. So let me do this quickly. And then go to the edit page. And here we have the fourth one, which is looking like this. Now let me show you the last one, which is very interesting. Just place the CDI right over here, hit Ctrl V to paste. Just go to the Fusion page. This time I will use only one text, so just delete these two nodes. Let me show you quickly. Just select the text one, keep it in center, remove the opacity animation first, and we don't have any animation, we have only the transform. Now let me animate the text. So just go to text. Here we have to use the follower modifier. So just right click on that, click on follower and go to the modifier. Just go to setting. Here we have the opacity. So we have to animate the opacity. So just go to frame number 60, right click on opacity, click on animate, go to a very first frame of this animation. So the opacity is 0. And here just go to frame number 210 and just right click on opacity, click on set key, go to 60 frame forward in time. So it should be frame number 270, set the opacity 0. You can also animate other parameters such as softness, and just go to timing. Here we have the delay. Let's set the delay 5 frames. You can see here we will get something like this. You can also change some setting. Just go to the order, set it to random but one by one, or you can also set it completely random, but this option is good, random but one by one. And now you can see here we will get this type of text animation, which is looking absolutely amazing. And now you can go to the edit page, and here we have the fifth text, which is looking like this. Alright, so using this technique you can animate other parameter as well. So let me show you the another one. Just go to the Fusion page again, select the text, go to modifier. So this is the spacing. You can animate the spacing, but we have to remove the first spacing, so which is in the tool. Just go to tool and set it to default. Perfect. And then go to the modifier. Here, just go to frame number 60. This is the spacing. Let's increase the spacing, maybe 1.1. Right click on spacing, click on animate, and then just go to very first frame and let's set the spacing maybe 1.3, and let's take a look. All right, now you can go to the edit page, and here we have little different text animation. Perfect. Go to very first frame, go to full screen, and let's have a look. Absolutely amazing, right? And that's a wrap for this tutorial. If you have any questions or thoughts, feel free to drop a comment below. And if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing and giving this video a thumbs up. My name is Vikash Kumar, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.